I spoke about forgiveness, and I'd like to speak about character and conduct. To develop your character and conduct is a duty that you owe one another, because it is huququl ibad. It's part of the rights of the rest of mankind and the rest of the worshippers, the rest of the Muslimin. Imagine if your character is not refined, what would happen? People would be suffering because of the way you carry yourself. How selfish we become. And this is why a selfish person will never contribute to community in a positive way. We need to become selfless to a certain extent. In moderation. Moderation meaning you don't give away everything such that you are now in need. And you don't keep everything that you're just watching the people in need. But a balance. This is why when the Prophet ﷺ explains about charity, he tells Mu'adh ibn Jabal to tell the people that at a certain point, once you have accepted Islam, there is something known as zakah, that is a pillar of Islam. تُؤْخَذُ مِنْ أَغْنِيَائِهِمْ فَتُرَدُّ فِي فُقَرَائِهِمْ. There is a right that the poor people have in the wealth of the wealthy. Did you know that? There is a right. And this is why when you give people who are poor in your society, community, and you have a massive business, they will pray for you, because they know when they walk past your store and they see this big place, mashallah, they say, oh Allah, help this man. Let him do well, because some of that money comes to me. 2.5% shares in that business. Subhanallah. The poor have 2.5% shares in your business. Do you know that? That's from Allah, whether you knew it or not. They are partners. The only thing is, it's up to you to give. And you make sure you give the people. I know, I have a habit. When I know that this person actually gives out in charity, I make sure I go to that business and I make sure that I pay fully. And I make sure that I buy as much as I can and I need from that particular business, because I know where the money is going. It's a habit. And you know, there was a time when, you know, it says here to respect the scholars and ulama is also a duty we have for the ummah. Because if we don't respect the scholars, the ummah loses value for those scholars. And who then is going to give you your deen? Who then is going to give you your faith and your religion? But we need to realize that scholars are not prophets. They may make mistakes. So correct them in a beautiful way, or at least excuse them if that mistake doesn't need proper correction. Sometimes they may be a little bit temperamental. You might have a scholar who comes in here, he's been upset because of what happened at home, and sometimes it reflects. Some people can hide it, you know. Some people can hide what has happened in the morning. Subhanallah. But others cannot hide it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. I need to share with you something. So I was waiting for my lift here just now a few minutes ago before I came here. And the brother had driven to the hotel, and he had gone to do something. And I knew that this talk begins. So we were sitting in this vehicle and waiting. I tried calling this one, tried calling that one, but I don't have all the numbers of all the relevant people, and I did not want to disturb, you know, some of the senior guys to say small things like a vehicle. When I saw that now there's just enough time to get here, I decided to jump on the driving seat and turn on the TomTom, you know, the Garmin, and I typed out Matrade. I got my friend who was with me to type it out, and I just drove off, and we came here. I came on my own. How did that happen? And then they phoned me, Sheikh, where are you? I said, brother, I was going to Uber it. Now you can Uber it, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. But at least I got here. Now, would you have known that? No, I didn't have an intention to say it. But because the topic was that, and I said it, sometimes it may show. I'm not angry, I'm not upset, and I hope nobody is. It was a way of dealing with the issue, such that we got here on time, mashallah. Subhanallah. And I enjoyed it. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters, remember, when we respect the scholars, we would actually be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the deen comes to us through them. The deen comes to us through them. So even if you have a gripe against a scholar, even if there is something that has happened, when you want to raise it, do so respectfully. The problem today that we have, people, even amongst one another, when something bad has happened, they say, expose this person, do this to that. If you expose someone, fair and good. Allah will expose you. So one of the rights and the duties we have that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has spoken about many times, he says, whoever covers the fault of a Muslim, Allah will cover their faults in this world and the next, and Allah will not embarrass them. So if you've been going around exposing people, wait for your day, it's coming. May Allah forgive us. But if you have, that does not mean don't deal with the problem. You may want to deal with it, but in a respectful manner, in a private way, in a way that you don't disturb the dignity of an individual. You know, imagine, there was an imam in one of the masajid, in one of the countries in southern Africa. And he was quite rough. And he used to know the community. The people started leaving the masjid one by one because he used to get up and say, you know, alcohol is very bad. This brother, and he would point at the brother. And he would say, with his name, say his name was Yunus, for example. He says, brother Yunus, he's been drinking for 20 years. Please get up and tell us, what have you gained from that? Tell us what. And this brother's like, huh? What? So to correct such a scholar, you need, and wallahi, this is factual. What I've told you is real. He spoke about alcohol, he spoke about adultery. He says, you know, this person here, what he's been doing is very bad. Get up and tell us, what's been going on? We're hearing a rumor. And he's like, what? Now they stop coming for Salatul Jummah. So we got to deal with it, because this is a big thing. But at the same time, deal with it respectfully. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. In this particular case, he was wrong to expose someone else, even to talk about them from a minbar. Tell you why. People come to get closer to Allah, to learn something good, to be inspired. Why are you here today? Why are you here? You are here to be inspired, to get something good, to get closer to Allah, to feel when you leave here that today I learned something. Today I had a really good time and it was so nice. I enjoyed it. There were beautiful brothers and sisters, mashallah. We learned, we laughed at the same time, and we cried also. And we walked out of here better people. That's why you are here. Am I right?
Yes.
There you are. Imagine if I were to pick on one of you, two of you, make this whole thing a big embarrassment, you would go away saying, never again. Straight path, no way, not at all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, and may He open our doors. So this is why we say, we need to definitely respect one another. We need to be there for one another. We need to understand that just like we would love to be covered, we need to cover others. We should not expose them. Between husband and wife, there are more rights than there are for the general Muslims. Within your family, there are greater rights than there are within the general Muslim. Subhanallah.